Hi, this is Reginald, and today I just wanted to have fun with some of the jazz basses that I currently have in my hands, because one of my friends has actually loaned me his amazing Sadowski US Wheelie model. I've been having so much fun with it, and I just put on a new set of strings, so I thought that it would be interesting to see the difference and hear the difference tonally between this Sadowski and some of the other jazz basses that I currently have. So this is the Wheelie model, beautiful flame maple neck, chambered body. So this bass is incredibly light, but with no loss in tone, flame maple fingerboard, drop D tuner, and for the Wheelie model, it actually has a switch where you can actually just activate the mid boost. So let's hear. It has a very nice snappy sound. I just love this sound. Perfect for slapping. Very smooth tone. And so if I flip this switch, you can hear that there's a mid boost. So it gives it a bit more body in the tone. And if I use the bridge pickup, roll off the tone a bit, give it a bit more bass. So this is actually the Wheelie bass, and you can hear that the mid-range, it's probably voiced a little bit slightly on the higher side, not exactly the low mids in the 200 or 400 range, but maybe slightly higher than that. Okay, so let's do a comparison. And this is the Exotic XJ1T 4 string bass. Let's get some volume. Let me just bring this back to flat. A bit more volume. This bass is a little snappier. So the treble, the bite right at the top end is a little different. And if we boost the 12K, so this bass has a bit more bite, not as smooth. So if you want something that cuts through a little bit more, I think this bass may just do the trick. And if we boost the mids, let's see how the finger style tone sounds like. So this bass, because I can actually switch the mid, so I'm actually able to get a bit more volume, a bit more meat in the 400 register. So this bass, for the Exotic, it sounds a little more mid-range in the lower mids as compared to Sadowski, which is maybe just voiced slightly higher. And so the third one, let's hear how the sandbox sounds. Okay, the difference with the sandbox bass is that this is an elder body compared to the other two, which has a ash body. So you can hear that it has a bit more mid-range naturally, even though the EQ is flat. But very nice slap tone as well. So if I just boost the treble and mid, treble and bass. So you can hear that the mid-range is probably not as snappy as the first two basses, but it does have a nice mid-range voice. And if we do that bridge pickup sound, this bass has a bit more mid-range, so perfect for the Jaco stuff. Sounds really good from here. So this is just a quick snapshot of the different jazz basses. It's really hard to compare whether one is better than the other because these are all the top jazz basses that you can find in the market today. So this is just a video to let you hear the different types of sound, although they are very similar in many ways, but just a little bit nuanced in the way that they are made, and really excellent basses. So Sadowski, really the top player in the market. They've been a benchmark for many basses, but I think coming up close, there are also other brands like Exotic, Sandberg, who are also making equally good jazz basses as well. So I can't really say who's number one or who's number three, but I really like them all. So you can make the decision yourself, and that's all for now. See ya.